estas tiendas y cómo desarrollar estas tiendas nuevas. So it is viewing a mirror folder, which we're going to enter just a little bit further on. And I was reclaimed from 1927 until 1930. That's the Beelze Dijk and pumped the water out. And that was mainly used for agriculture, as we needed that desperately. But nowadays, with all this new land we have for agriculture and with the mechanization, it's not that necessary anymore on this agriculture land. So the Wieringer Meer is also used for other purposes, and you will see that in a little moment. Das ist der Wieringer Meer, der fue hecho 1927 hasta 1930. 30 kilometers long. It's the dike is 90 meters wide, 90 from the water level, and it's 7 to 8 meters high. In a moment we arrive at the place where the last gap in the dike was closed in May 1932, and they've made a monument there in the form of an outlook tower which you can climb, and it's really nice. You have a beautiful view on the lake and the sea and the dike, of course. At the foot of the monument is a cafeteria where you can get a coffee, and they have very nice photos over there and a short film showing you how this last gap was closed in that time. And there's also a statue of this engineer Lely overlooking his work. It's a little bit sad, he died in 1929, so he never...
inside the barn again. And that's because he didn't have the space for all the cows to eat here, so he had to go to the nature. And yeah, in this village we do everything by boat.
Of course you don't need the hospital here. Of course not.
A hospital?
You don't need. You are so much healthy.
Yeah, but with all the...
No pollution. No crowded. No noise.
Yeah, in summer it's fully crowded and people crash into each other.
Is it crowded?
Yeah. Right now it's quiet because of all the rain.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have two fast cars, but it's really funny to see how the boat, with the koeien. Yeah, yeah, it's heel grappig. So if you can pass them on, you have an idea what they did in the past.
But in summer, the whole village will be filled with boats, everyone crashing into each other. People can't drive the boats, will rent them and then just play games with it, so crash into everyone. And that's really chaotic. And people, we always say, put your hands inside the boat. Because maybe your driver is really good at driving the boat, but the others aren't. So when you got your hands out of the boat, someone crashed into it, you lost a finger. So we got a hospital, a city nearby. But yeah, you're not able to get everywhere with the car. So they even got a chopper for the hospital, so they can land into a backyard of someone to get there fast. And of course, yeah, the insurance for the houses, fire insurance, really high.
Fire.
Because we the roof and the firemen are not able to get fast to the houses. I think we got a couple fireman boats, but the cars are not able to get here, or not fast enough. So you got a really high insurance. So at the left side you can see the mill of the village. As you can see, the mill hasn't any wings. This man didn't have the money to repair the wings and repair the house every 10 years. So he sold the wings and with that money he repaired the house. From that moment he started an information center for tourists. But right now the information center has moved next to the bus station because of all the tourists who are entering the village over there. And now this is just a house for living, so people live here. This house is a beautiful house, beautiful garden, and they just drive with the boat to their backyard and they park the boat over here. It's a beautiful spot over here.
Thank you.
how the boat was there, it doesn't even that hard. It makes it hard for all the tourists. It makes it hard because of all the tourists. Or just
because you cannot see.
Yeah, put it in backwards and I need to brake, I need to steer, they will try to get in front of me, and then they will press at the side, and then that makes it hard. Just driving the boat and leaving the line. Yeah, you need to meet in our house and you get to see you.
To say in a cruise ship.
Yeah, well, maybe.
The one with 6,000 passengers.
Yeah. The next corner is the hardest because you need to go. It's like an S form. You need to go to the right and then directly to the left. So here on the right side you can see an old wooden boat at the side. The man who lives here is one of the two left boat builders. This man, Mr. Schreur, is building all the touring boats. So the boat we are in now, being built by this man. And he builds all the wooden touring boats in the village. The other boat builder is in the northern part of the village, and he's building all the small boats, the small wooden boats, just like one of these. And he also rents them, so he builds them and rents them to tourists. He only put an engine behind it, and then even you can drive the old traditional wooden boat. The one who started about 80 till 85, he is alive still, but his son is now in the company, so his son is now building those.
Thank you.